Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved one, today is 25th day of November, being Thursday, and week 34. And today the Mother Church celebrates St. Catherine of Alexandria, Virgin and Martyr. And readings will be coming from Prophet Daniel chapter 6, verse 11 to 27. And response to Psalm will come from Daniel chapter 3, verse 46b. Our gospel message will come from Luke Gospel chapter 21, verse 20 to 28. The theme of our message today is God who delivers. We worship a God who delivers us from all our problems. For he who loves God, everything works unto good. The just man will suffer many things, but God will deliver him from all those things. That was the promise of God to all of us, who are his disciples. And that's why Jesus began to speak to his disciples today, say, when you see Jerusalem surrendered by armies, you know the hour of his desolation has come. When you saw it surrendered by armies, you know the hour of his desolation is at hand. So when you see soldiers surrender your whole place in your area, you know the hour for destruction, killing has come. And you should do everything to avoid them or to escape from their hands. So no desolation has come. Then he said, those in Judea should flee to the mountain. Those in the city will depart from it. Those outside should not enter back again. He's advising them what to do. He says the door of vengeance, that all that had been written will be fulfilled. See, nothing happens without being prophesied, that God will prophesy it earlier before it happens. He said, alas for that day, for women who were children, they will lament having children. Who are nursing babies, they will lament it. For great distress will be upon this earth. The distress you have never experienced will be upon this earth. In face of all distress, when all these things are happening, the seas are tumbling, everything are falling down, mountains are crumbling, the heavens are shaking. In face of all distress, Jesus is warning you. You will see the Son of Man coming in the cloud in his glory and power. He said, when these things begin to take place, he said, look up, raise your heads, because it means your redemption is close at hand. In face of all those terrible things happening there and there, raise up your head, stand up erect. Know that because your redemption is close at hand, the hour of redemption, the hour of their deliverance is close at hand. The God who will deliver you, not any other person. Nothing will save you. That's why it makes a mockery of Christian faith when we begin to think government can save us from COVID-19. Or taking vaccine will save us from COVID-19. Or thinking that closing your mouth will save you from COVID-19. That is a testimony of a faithless generation. It's only God who will save you from these situations. If we understand it, it will make all the difference in our lives. And that's why today God has to show us Daniel. Daniel was praying every time he goes to pray. And some gang of people decided to discover Daniel and went to follow him closely and discovered they found him praying. And they went to the king and said, look, it's the law of the Chaldeans that any law made by the king cannot be changed. Another convinced the king, said this, now we have caught Daniel praying, and the law is that he will be thrown to the den of lions. The king was looking all the way to deliver Daniel. He couldn't find. These people were following him bumper to bumper, quoting the law for him. This is the law. And the king said, okay, throw Daniel, put Daniel into the, that Daniel is not worshiping the idol, the abomination the king has enthroned. Who gave the order that no person should worship any other thing except the idol he enthroned? And the king was not, even though Daniel is worshiping on that God, he's not worried about it. So he wanted to deliver Daniel, but he couldn't find an answer way to it. They followed him bumper to bumper. And eventually he said, okay, throw into the distance, brought his seal, closed the mouth of the den, and he put his seal so that no person can open it or change it. And the king went and had a sleepless night. He was fasting, he was keeping vigil, praying for God, saying, may the God of Daniel deliver him. Let the God of Daniel deliver him. And since I cannot do anything, since I'm handicapped now, let the God of this God you have worshipped, let him deliver you. Daniel, let God deliver you. And the king will not sleep. He will not want to be distracted. He doesn't want anything. He kept alone that night, praying and asking God to deliver Daniel. And early in the morning, he got up and ran to the dean. I begin to call, Daniel, Daniel, has your God delivered you? And Daniel answered from the den of lions, yes, my God has sent angels to close the mouth of the lions. They didn't hurt me, had delivered me. And he gave order for them to go and bring out Daniel. And they went and brought Daniel out, no hurt, nothing. But he was with the lions all the night. That was him, he closed the mouth of the lions. They couldn't even hurt him. They sleep with him. To show you the power of God to deliver us. We thought it's not that Daniel's effort. And Daniel was telling the king, and when the king discovered that Daniel was not hurted, he was so happy. He was exceedingly glad. Oh, he began to praise the God of Daniel, a living God who delivered his own, who worshiped him continually. And Daniel said, yes, he saved me because I found me blameless. I'm not blamed in the sight of God. Neither was I blamed in the sight of you. I haven't done no wrong. He just decided to put me into the den of lions. And when the king saw that God has delivered Daniel, not any human being, and he began to praise the God of Daniel. And made a decree. He made a decree in his whole nation. He said, this God of Daniel cannot be destroyed. He's a living God. His kingdom is forever. He began to proclaim. He began to testify. Bear testimony for this God. And he said, he delivers and rescues his own people. Begin to talk about the attributes of the God. He said he delivers and rescues. He works signs and wonders in heaven and on earth. He has saved Daniel from the power of lions. He made a decree and that they should worship this God now, a living God. Do you see how God delivered Daniel? So he said all this in turning against the faith of Daniel. He now promoted the faith of Daniel. You need to say we are good Christians in the world. COVID-19 could have given opportunity to convert the whole world and made them know the truth about life. That is God who delivers. Not COVID-19, not China. A person who promotes evil cannot help you out of evil. Rather, he will continue mechanizing you till he destroys you. So it's only God who worship a God who delivers. The God who delivered Daniel is the God we are worshiping. He will deliver us from all the lions around us, all the snares around us, from all the pandemic around us, if we believe in him. If our life is blameless, if we trust in him, he will deliver us. So our God delivers. The psalmist who understood it so well, they say, sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Because he's the one who delivers you. No other person did it for you. And no person could do it for you except him. If you have a God who delivers from, why are you panicking? Why are you worried when you have a God who delivers from all situations? Your own will be different. He did it for Daniel. He did promise you to what he's faithful. Your own will not be different. All you need to be, remain stable in your faith. Trust him more. No shaking. And that way today, the mother just said, Brace and Carolyn of Alexandria, Virgin and Martha. History has it, people who are testimony all over the place, that St. Catherine was an outspoken, very outspoken in the time of persecution of Christians. You know, when people have been persecuted, everybody run away, no one to get involved. But this lady, very elegant, amazing of a lady, was criticized, was challenging, and they protested even to the emperor. Mazentus. He presented the president, went to him and said, what you are doing is wrong. Why are you doing all this? Why are you killing people? Why should you do this? You see the courage of this lady. And she was arrested, tortured, and killed in 305. But what about her life is that she's an outspoken lady. A full of courage. He's not afraid to die. And he speaks out everywhere, especially when you see people suffering. I think that's the courage we need in Nigeria and Africa. You can't be talking of justice when you are not ready to speak out. You can't be talking of peace when you are not ready to speak out. Many of us are cowards today. And when you come out and speak, they will start blaming you. Why do you talk? You could have kept quiet. You are already getting old. You see, some people will, you see, why should you talk? You could have kept quiet. Especially when you talk and they begin to persecute you. They will probably start mourning and coming to tell you, you see, you could have not said that. You could have kept quiet. You are not the only person there. When you do this, life of Kathleen will contradict you. She's a virgin and a matter of the church. Outspoken. Someone who have the gift of outspeak in issues. Persecution is all around us. Snares is all around us. But we're not discouraged, because if we are saying our own, if we are saying it out of our own, if we are saying it to get compensated or to be recognized, then we'll put to shame. But if you are saying it and God inspires you to say it, you criticize this and challenge it, nothing will happen. They can only make noise, but nothing will happen to you. Kathleen spoke out. And that's what is lacking in Christian faith in Africa. That was lacking in Christian faith in Nigeria. And that what we're breeding sycophants and promoting evil all over the place. No person can speak out. Our prophetic role has gone to beans and rice and money. A little gift, you forgo your faith, you forgo your prophecy, you forgo your ministry. Because of material things, that percentage. Kathleen contradicted this today. Since we know that God will deliver us, he will deliver us even though they kill our body, he will deliver us, our souls and body in it. Kathleen was killed today, she's delivered. How was the mother church is celebrating her all over the world today? And they're going to celebrating her. She died in 305. This is year 2021, and she's still being celebrated. You see how she was delivered. We ask God to help us to understand this today, that our God delivers. And we should trust him. We should live before him blamelessly, trusting him and living him. And he will deliver us from all problems. We ask through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us, in the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.